12. Now you see the job seeker who has a family, who has needs a job right away. They come into the career center looking for not always education and training, but the next job to get that dollar. How do you navigate that person into a pathway? How do you, on this side, we think a lot about the creation and development of pathways, but how do you put the pathway into practice to quickly serve the need of that job seeker who comes into a career center?
We're very, very lucky in Henderson County, North Carolina, at Blue Ridge Community College, because our NC Works Center is on the college campus. That allows us to take the resources that Blue Ridge Community College has towards education, towards the value of having the student, the future employee there, while allowing the community to come onto campus. So number one, I have a little bit of an advantage that some areas don't have. The other thing is again, as you mentioned, the leadership of Nathan Ramsey and Tim Mathis and Dr. Leatherwood, we have leadership that already is a part of this gathering of pathways. So not even at the bottom line, to take it where you want to. How do we assist those people in moving forward? You know, I'd like to tell you there's a lot of rocket science and there's a lot of this and something else to it, but the reality is back on this table in the back here, there are some little sheets of paper, and it shows the matrix that Barbara and Nathan and all these employers have put together. Now that might seem like it's just another sheet of paper, but the reality is every one of my staff people, whether they are employed, quote unquote, by the college, or whether they are from the Department of Commerce, every one of them has on their desk all three of our pathways. Now that does not mean that it applies to every person that walks in, but when you're in a county like Henderson, that is a high manufacturing county, high healthcare, high hospitality, the fact that we can pull these out and immediately, right from the get-go, say, the person's like, well, you know, I'm really kind of interested in hospitality. To pull that out, to sit down and say, this was designed not, no offense to y'all here in Raleigh, not designed in Raleigh. This was designed right here in our local area. These are the jobs. This is what it pays. Please pick one of these up and look at what we're doing. And here's the education. So it allows all of us to be, if this makes sense, the 30-second expert in the job field. Where Robert can sit here and talk in hospitality in grand detail, the reality is that somebody in a career center doesn't have that background. But with that pathway in front of us, it allows us to walk a student through, to look at where it goes and what is going to be needed. And the fact that we're right on the, that we are housed with the continuing education unit at Blue Ridge, and on top of that, we're right there where we have curriculum. We have the answers to where we can get the students. I think the governor said it wonderfully, where it was from middle school to middle age or something in that. We serve all of them out of one office, and this work through the pathways, through the industry, has allowed us to communicate very, very simply what you need to do. But not only that, but it allows my staff to say, here's how I can help you.
Thank you so much for that, Scott. One thing you said I really appreciate, we don't take offense that, that the path